Yo, this is your boy Bronze. You're listening to the Toy Thug Show.
Yo, that movie.
I got my co-host with me, KP.
Yo.
Gray Miles.
Yes, sir.
Now that we have your attention.
This is episode 39.
The Black Panther lives.
39. The King T'Challa of episodes.
There you go.
We ain't doing no athletes this week. Because there isn't one, but, you know, we have a kind of a special Black Panther episode, so we're going to T'Challa for this one.
Yes, sir. Check us out at toythug.com, home of the pop culture goodies. You can check us out on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, SoundCloud, YouTube. And yeah, pretty much we're going to cover Black Panther, dope movie. But before that, we're going to talk a little bit of this past weekend, the Toy Fair 2018. Yep, quite a bit of dope toys. I think we're going to go over our favorite toys. Let's go with Gray Miles. What was your favorite toy?
It was kind of hard to narrow it down because there was like a ton of Marvel Legends, a ton of Funko Pops, a ton of Black Series. But I'm going to go with Transformer Power of the Primes. Predakeen,
man,
always been one of my favorite G1s, and they're basically re-releasing him with like a newer style, and I saw that, I was like, man, that's the one, that's the must have in 2018 right there for me. So
did they say when that's gonna come out?
I mean, the one good thing about all this is, like, I remember last year's Toy Fair, like, some of that stuff is just now coming out, so at least it's going to be spread out, because if it was going to be like a compacted thing, I mean, that'd be, you know, murder on your wallet. So I'm not sure when it's coming out, but eventually, yeah, at some point in 18 or maybe early 19, but it is coming out. So that's my pick.
Yes, sir. Man, like, speaking of Marvel Legends, man, they came with it. There was a lot.
Yeah, there was a ton of Marvel Legends. A ton.
I was like, okay. And then I thought it was done. And I'm like, oh, there's some more. I'm like, whoa, this is...
Yeah, they pretty much revealed stuff like the entire weekend.
Right. Now, that 10th anniversary Marvel Legends and right, Marvel right. Studios.
The MCU, yeah.
Yes. My favorite out of all of the Toy Fair was the Hulkbuster versus Hulk. Marvel Legends.
Oh, right. I did see that.
Yeah. So is that a Build-A-Figure?
No, it's just like it's a two-pack of a Hulk and a Hulkbuster.
Yeah, almost the size of a Build-A-Figure, I guess. But yeah, they're big and detailed.
Really?
Yeah. I know we talked about it before that Hasbro's coming up, but they've really stepped up. I mean, it's, I'm not going to say SH Figure Arts level, but it's their head sculpt is really on point now. And with the KP, what was yours?
There's only one that I really like followed, and it had to be the co-pilot Chewie. Could basically teach it to do things, and then, you know, has a bunch of different movements and phrases that you could, you know, interact with it. You even like tickle his toes, and like he gets mad and stuff. I thought that was kind of cool. But that's really the only one I really had a chance to kind of really follow. I saw a news article or a news video footage of it, and I read up on it, and I was like, man, this thing is pretty cool. And I think it's definitely going to be a hot seller during Christmas time next
year.
That's
what I'm thinking. It might be like Tickle Me Elmo level.
Yeah, for sure, dude. The thing is so dope. You know, I'd have it rock with me in the ride, driving everywhere.
I think the retail on that is $129.
Word?
Yeah.
Man.
It's not going to be cheap, so.
I was like,
if it sells out, you can see it go up to like $300 maybe. If it's, you know, everything works out, you know, the way they planned it to.
Right. So I also want to add with the Star Wars line, man, I know we talked about it last week with Donald Glover. I mean, Lando straight looks like Childish Gambino, man, the figure.
Yeah, they're finally doing that digital face thing, and like they actually really look like the actors now. Like, right. Really look like them.
The, what do you call it, snow trooper?
Oh, yeah, I'm not sure what his official title is, but that thing looks cool, man.
Super dope. Yeah. It has fur.
It's got like a little fur collar, man.
Yes.
So what is y'all's like overall feeling of the whole the Solo movie coming out right now? Like, are you feeling like it's going to be, are y'all excited about it? Or is it like, do you feel like it might be a flop? Or what's the what's the word right now with you guys?
I'm leaning towards excited.
Yeah.
But there's a little bit of paranoia too.
Yeah.
Because this might be the movie that might stop the momentum of, you know, releasing all the Star Wars. But I mean, I got faith in Ron Howard, man.
Yeah.
Shout out to.
What makes you say that? Like, why do you, why are you concerned about momentum?
Is it because of Solo? The way he looks, he kind of doesn't fit the Solo. You know how you envisioned young Solo to be? Is that what it might be?
He does. He, I, you know, it, we only saw a teaser.
Yeah.
So, but so far the initial reaction is like, I don't know.
Yeah. I mean, you never know until you see the acting, right? You don't see, you can't really tell.
Yeah.
I mean, you could go by, you know, how it looks, but it really, you know, matters on like how he brings it as far as with, you know, the theatrics.
Yes.
So I
especially
think,
with all the criticism people are bashing, especially from the last movie. I mean, it still, it made money and it was a smash hit. I just don't want to see the hate to continue. I mean, it probably will.
Of course. Some, there's, I mean,
it's already started.
Yeah, man. There's always going to be hate, man. Like, if this does well, what other backstory movie would y'all want to see?
I'm not sure. But I want, before we do that, I want to hear what Gray Miles' take on... are you excited, Gray Miles? Or
I mean, I'm looking forward to Donald Glover, as I've always been this whole time. I'm not really, when they first announced it, I wasn't that interested anyway, because I, like I said, I've never been a Han Solo dude. But I mean, I'm willing to give it a chance, because I mean, the trailer looked pretty good, but that was like 2 minutes, so you really don't know. But I mean, I'll give it a shot. I mean, I'm looking forward to it, and I'll definitely probably buy my tickets in advance like I do with every other Star Wars movie. So, you know, I'll be there. I'm here for it, but, you know, I guess it tempered excitement, I guess, is what I can call it best.
Yes, that's, yeah.
Yeah.
Did you see the front? I finally saw the front, like, you know, like a good look at it.
Yeah, it's one piece. It's one piece.
And I'm like, okay.
Oh, actually, they spoiled it at Toy Fair. It's supposedly, like, the front part is like a escape ship, escape pod kind of thing. That's what it is, so.
You're talking about the front of the Falcon?
Yeah, it's one piece in Solo.
Oh, wow. Okay.
And it's supposedly that piece that you see as one, it's like an escape pod. So I guess they use it, and now it's not attached anymore. That's why you see, like, the, you know, the old school Falcon is like two pincer type of thing.
Right.
Yeah, that's why. Basically, they use it with the escape pod.
That's crazy.
If the toy... spoiler is accurate, you know, sometimes it's not, but I'm guessing that it is.
Yeah,
that Lego set that they released recently on Amazon, and I think Lego.com released it. Is that the model of the Millennium Falcon from the Solo movie?
Nah, that's the OG.
That's the OG one. Oh, okay.
And also, by the way, that was in and out of stock all day today on Toys R Us. If you were like trying to cop that, it was like flickering in and out of stock all day.
Really?
Yeah.
So Toys R Us has it too. Wow.
Yeah.
I also want to add about the. Did you guys see the that barge, the Return of the Jedi?
Yeah, Hasbro's doing a crowdfunder for the Jabba sail barge. Because I guess.
They're doing a crowdfund?
Yeah, because I guess, like, well, they've done vehicles in the past that have been big and expensive, and they wound up going on clearance.
Oh, okay.
Which is not good for anybody, so.
Wow.
They're going to do, like, a crowdfunding. It's going to be $500, and they're asking for 5,000 people. Last I heard, they were 1,000, so. I mean, I guess that's a good start, but, yeah, it's
it should be
cool. It should be pretty big if it gets made.
Yeah. But
right now, you're not sure, so.
Because it's for the 3.25-inch.
Right, but it's supposed to be, like, I guess, accurate to scale, so it's going to be, like, hella big.
Yeah.
Supposedly, I heard it's, like, the biggest vehicle ever produced if they do make it.
Yeah, I saw the blueprint or whatever you call it.
Yeah.
You would see, like, Jabba in there. Now, I don't know if Jabba comes with it or that was just like kind of just to show the scale.
I don't know. I just know that it's supposedly the biggest Star Wars vehicle ever made, if it does get made.
So, yeah, I don't blame them for going the crowdfunding route then. Because, you know, that's kind of, you know, different. I mean, have you ever heard of a big name company like Hasbro doing like a crowdfunding?
Oh, yeah, that is.
That's kind of different. Like, you know, kind of putting that, you know, marketing into the mainstream, I think, you know, if a big name company is doing stuff like that.
Exactly. And I guess it's just pretty much to give love to the fans, because I know how it, with Hasbro, they want to appease to the collectors too. Financially, it doesn't make sense.
Yeah, for sure. Right?
For them.
Yeah.
Maybe doing this, and if it's a success.
Yeah, because they already paid for it already by, you know, putting in your pledge or whatever to the crowdfund, right? So, right. It's already paid for. So that's pretty cool. I'm glad, like, you know, the big companies are starting to look into, you know, the kind of like the newer forms of product creation and like funding. You know, that's pretty cool.
Yes. Great Miles, are you going to get one?
No, a little bit too rich for me.
What is the price point on that?
$500.
Man, hold up.
You know, like with crowdfunding, there's different levels of whatever donation or whatever.
You get half a barge.
Yeah, but I'm pretty sure that it's just five. Like, I don't think there's different levels.
Okay.
I think if you pledge five, you're going to get one. The thing is, it's going to be hella expensive to make, to produce. So, and I don't think I have anywhere to put it. I mean, it's supposed to be like hella huge. So.
Right.
Wow.
Come on, Star Wars fans, where you at?
I mean, I want to see one. I want to see one.
How many more? 4,000?
4,000. The
last I heard it was that 1,000 people, they're asking for 5,000. I'm sure it's gone up by now. By how much?
There's going to be some rich, like, dude that's just going to buy all just the rest of them just to get it made.
He'll flip it.
Yeah, right?
For 1,000.
Then he's going to hoard them and keep them on eBay.
I would imagine the value on this thing will be crazy high, like in a few years or whatever, like maybe like 10 years from now.
Right. Yeah.
It'll be like highly collectible at that point. But
yes.
Wow. Like, how big is big? How what's the size again?
I'm not sure if they gave the measurements. All I heard was it was supposed to be like the biggest Star Wars toy ever made.
Dang.
All right, let me ask you guys this. What was the biggest Star Wars toys that you guys ever had?
I have
your mom bought it.
I have the Black Series TIE Fighter that came out a couple years ago.
Oh, okay, yeah.
And speaking of clearance, like that went on clearance. So, I mean, I think the retail was like $180 at one point. I think you could find it like at Ross and Marshall's for like $50.
Yes.
So yeah, that's definitely not good for retail. So that's probably why they're doing this. Because I have another, I got basically the AT-ATs from Rogue One for like $30.
What? Does it do?
Like, it was like, it retailed like at $300. So,
dude, yeah,
it's good for me, but hell, it's bad for retail, you know?
All right, I'll say it now. Gray Miles be winning. $30 to $300, man.
Dude, that is like a 300% markdown or something.
Yeah, for sure. Wow, that's crazy.
What about you, KP?
One that I bought in as a kid, you mean?
I mean, or, like all through, you know, all time.
I mean, I bought stuff and not opened it. Like, recently, we got the Lego Millennium Falcon. I'm sure that thing is pretty big.
You have that?
Yeah, well, yeah, I mean, you know, we're going to...
You're going to build it?
I don't know about building it.
Let's do a time lapse.
I know, right? That would be cool. There's like 5,000 pieces.
Yeah, someone says like it took about 23 hours.
Oh, somebody did it already?
Yeah.
Wow.
That's
like
long.
24 hours. Like, he went like hardcore with it.
Yeah.
He did it like every day.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Sitting down all day doing it.
Yeah.
My attention span wouldn't last probably like 5 hours.
I can't remember I think the biggest one, I don't know which is bigger, the Death Star, that Tower Death Star, or the Falcon. But I got both of those, or had both of those.
Oh, they released like basically a true to scale Falcon like 5-10 years ago. That's like over 2 feet long. I had that too. That was pretty dope.
Yeah.
Yeah. As a kid, I didn't really have too many Star Wars toys. We were kind of Poe. But
good.
Well, no, I had like the little figure, just 3.5-inch figure. But like, as far as like the big things, like, no.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wasn't.
Yeah, man.
About that life back then. I wanted it so bad, but like, yeah, you know, I had to steal it, and that's not right.
Man, speaking about that life, man, T'Challa.
Here we go,
man.
Black Panther, let's get to it, man. So what do you guys think, man?
Go ahead.
Gray Miles.
Best solo MCU movie of all time.
All time? Wow.
Easily.
Y'all gonna make me sound like a hater.
Maybe you gotta give love to the first Iron Man, because it started all this, but...
That's my number one, yeah.
If you look at, like, the cultural significance of this movie, I think it's the best one ever.
Wow.
Best solo movie, because I feel like First Avengers and Civil War are slightly better. But, yeah, in my opinion, it's the best solo MCU.
Yeah, if you're throwing in the solo MCU movies, it's definitely
it can be that
top five. That. But it's not. I felt like there was other movies that were better. I mean,
which movies, Graham?
Like I like Homecoming better. You know, I thought Homecoming.
Wow, really?
To me, Homecoming was better than Black Panther.
Okay.
The first Iron Man movie is pretty much on my top list because, you know, that's the kind of one that started it all. It's the one that got me excited.
How about Guardians of the Galaxy?
Guardians? No, not really. The second one is actually better to me than the first one, I felt. As far as solo, Iron Man would be my first. Homecoming, can't really think of off the top now. Like
Black Panther top three, then. Black Panther 3?
Yeah, that's good. Top 3.
You know, like, I really don't want to be a hater because the movie was really good. You know what I mean? But I just didn't feel like it lived up to the hype to me. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Yeah,
wow.
Like, I thought, like, I mean, there's been other black superheroes to me, like Blade, you know? Blade was, like, mm-hmm.
Yeah,
you know,
Blade was dope.
Blade to
but
me
I mean, like,
was,
he,
was
they're making, like, a point that he is black. You know, the other ones, he just happened to be black. But they're making, like, a real point to, like, play up his blackness. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's.
As far as like, you know, what he stands for, you know, the current situation, I think it's dope. But like, I think that's all blown up by kind of like social media to me, because, you know, nobody made a big deal that, you know, Blade was out there before or like.
But it's a completely different movie. You know, like it's not even like the same message like at all.
Okay. What is the message to you?
I mean, did you hear what he said at the end about, you know, you don't build bridges, you build bridges, not barriers.
Yeah.
I mean, how important is that to like, today's society? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Blade didn't do that at all. You know, they didn't do any of that stuff.
Yeah. I just felt like the whole black thing was kind of like it is being hyped up a little bit. But, you know, I definitely love what he stands for, you know, for the black community, you know, because, you know, Blade. Yeah, it was more of like a mature audience film. You know what I mean? Like with the whole vampire thing. And, you know, Black Panther definitely gives, you know, a positive, strong superhero character for the black community. And you know, I think other races would find, you know, Black Panther, you know, a favorite to them. You know what I mean?
You can relate. Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, like, but
I can relate.
To me, it just didn't live up to the hype of as far as like the acting. The message was great. You know, like,
yeah. Okay. Let's do this because. Okay, let's start it off with like with the movie itself, the story, because you know with this movie it has multiple levels to
yes,
it.
Yes,
I mean
definitely.
you can just play and enjoy the surface part of it.
Yeah,
right. I mean it is a Marvel,
and I'm looking at it from just the movie itself and like the acting, the fighting scenes. Yeah. I'm not looking at like the total message of it. You know what I'm saying? And like you know, and then I guess that's what you know that's what pushes it over the edge for you as being one of the top movies. But like to me, I looked past that. I just looked at it as you know a superhero movie, and kind of what you know my take on it.
Yeah, I mean, and on that, I thought the pacing was good. Basically, his first solo movie. I mean, we did see his little intro in Civil War, but this is pretty much introduction to his world. I liked it from the beginning to end. Some people were saying that you know it started off slow. I'm like,
yeah, I've read that a couple places. That like, was kind of slow at the beginning, but I didn't think so at all.
Yeah, it was a steady pace.
It was dope. Yeah, I like the you know the pace of the movie. But to me, the character that stole the show was Michael B. Jordan. You know,
Killmonger is like the best villain.
He stole the show for me. You know what I mean? Like the thing is,
he's not just a bad guy.
Yeah,
you know, like you can kind of see his motivation. I mean, he actually wants to do like good things.
Yeah,
but his measures are just too extreme.
Right.
So. Yeah, for sure.
He's actually kind of like the opposite of T'Challa in that regard.
He's basically what the real Black Panther Party stood for, as far as his way of thinking. You know what I mean? Like. You know, just kind of like forceful, aggressive, like make them listen type approach.
That's, you know, and that's why when T'Challa was like, was mad, you know, he's kind of was mad at his dad when he found out, you know, what went down in Oakland.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, that's his cousin and he left him there and he's saying but that's why he is what he is. Like he came back, you know, to Wakanda to try to take the crown.
Yeah.
T'Challa, he could see, you know, where he's coming from. One of the dopest villains, because what they say, like one of the best villains you can have is something a character that you can empathize with.
Yeah,
see where he's coming from.
Yeah, I like
a lot of like superhero movies. Like he's just like a bad guy. He's just evil to be evil.
Yeah, just
he has motivations of why he's that way. You can kind of see it. I mean, his father was taken from him at a young age. He was abandoned. And now he sees all this injustice and he wants to make it right. And he has the tools to make it right. But it's just like his measure to extreme. But he actually has good intentions. And I think you can easily sympathize, especially with, like, with today's world. You can see why he'd want to change things. And, and if you have the power to do it, why wouldn't you do it, you know?
Yeah.
I think in a lot of ways, he kind of wakes up to Cha, like, dude, like, you guys have all this power.
At the end, like,
you're just kind of sitting on the sideline. Like, you can't do it anymore, you know? So I think in a lot of ways, his fight with Killmonger kind of woke him up. Like, we can't just be passive anymore. We have to, you know, take steps here.
So what did he, at the end, he bought, like, all those buildings to build kind of like
a community center.
A community center for Wakanda, right? To kind of, like,
outreach to, like, Oakland or whatever.
Yeah.
Or I guess they'll do it in other places.
Or is that to find other Wakandans?
No. I think it's, like, community outreach.
I feel like, you know, we kind of move forward. But, you know, since we're there, it's, you know, wrapping that up, you know, at that end, at the end of the movie when, you know, the little kid, you know, was like, whoa, you know, that one kid that went up to, you know, T'Challa, like, who are you? That was a message of inspiration. Anybody that, you know, whether you're from the top or you're from the bottom, giving that the chance and is basically giving back to the community, right? Mm-hmm. So it was such a good, like, message right there. It was all wrapped up. If I was from Wakanda, like, when I was watching the movie, it's like, man, if I'm, you know, from Wakanda, I don't know if I would want any outsiders, you know, coming in. You know, I could see why they hid the city. I don't want to give the vibranium away, and the whole society was prosperous, right?
Yeah.
With all that. But then his love interest, you know, she's out there helping out the people that's outside of the city, people that's out there, and all the was it not the warmongers, but the warhounds out, you know, that sprinkled out all over the world helping out, you know, their peoples. There's that time where with T'Challa as well, you know, I'm here to protect, you know, my people's in the city, you know, my country, but, like, what about the other people's out there?
Yeah.
And it's, his eyes were opened up off of that. So, like, at the end of the movie, that's when he opened up, like, okay, yo, you know, he announced, you know, the United Nations, like, yo, we're about to help out. And he goes, well, what do you guys have to offer? You guys are third world country. I said, well, not really. You know, it's like, dang, that's so dope. And it's not just like it's about us. It's about we.
Yeah.
It's like one tribe, you know, the whole world is one tribe. We got to help each other out no matter what, like, if, what race is, like, there. He opened up the borders, basically. It was closed in, and he just decided, okay, I'm going to open it up.
Yeah, I got you. But I think, like, the characters for me, like, that's what made the movie. You know what I mean? Like, the sister, she was like the comic relief, Shuri.
I love her. Yeah,
yeah, she was dope, so right? Dope. You know, I loved her character. And
super,
you know,
genius.
Yeah, she was like the character in James Bond that
yes.
She was like the African version of that. You know what I mean? Like, the one that has all the gadgets.
Yeah,
and, like,
the scientist dude.
Yeah. So I thought her character was super funny, and it fit perfectly with kind of like the wide range of personalities within the characters, you know?
She goes, what are those?
That was funny. Yeah, she was,
she,
like,
hooked them up with that tech with those real sneakers. It was like straight silence.
Yeah, and some of the tech that they were showing, like, you know, I had to kind of remind myself, and I was like, you know, because I was kind of like, oh, really? That's kind of over the top, you know, kind of like. But then you think that tech, the vibranium, is like a alien form of technology, you know, so it's like way above whatever, you know, is out there within the Marvel Universe right now, you know what I mean? So I kind of have, like, I had to kind of, like, think of that. To kind of, like, okay, so this tech is, like, super out of this world, you know what I mean? Where is that supposed to, like, the vibranium? I know it's an alien, kind of like an alien, but where did it come from? Like, what was the backstory on that?
I mean, they've never said in the movie.
They never said in the comic books?
Maybe they have, but I don't know.
Yeah.
But I know in the MCU, they've never said, like, exactly where it comes from.
Yeah, watch it come from, like, Thanos or something, the Beyonders or you know, that group of, what are the characters' name that Infinity Wars is kind of being based off of? Like, you remember that scene where Stan Lee was sitting out in space, and he was with all those kind of, like, supreme beings?
Those are the Beyonders.
The Beyonders, right? Like,
or the Watchers.
Yeah.
The Watchers.
I'm thinking that's where kind of, like, that came from. I don't know.
What do you call it? Anything that, Grandma's, anything that you would nitpick on?
I mean, the fight scenes, like, when they were in the cave.
Yeah.
Like when they were falling down the cave, that did look a little cartoony to me at stretches. Mm-hmm. But at that point, it didn't really matter. You know, I didn't really care. I mean,
yeah.
To me, that was a minor thing. I mean, yes, I guess how I could take away from the movie if you're looking like just as purely like superhero movie, because like the effects weren't 100. But I mean, that's really my only beef with the movie was that was like the effects weren't
all that.
You know, especially in that one scene, you could really kind of tell that it looked like a cartoon.
Yeah.
But other than that, I mean, it was a damn good movie, man. So.
No, I'm not going to say it wasn't a good movie. I just thought, as far as with the hype, it didn't, you know, live up to what I felt.
But
the
I
hype
mean,
was
like the hype is based on the social commentary.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying? But like you're saying, it wasn't. You're not looking at it that way.
Yeah, I'm not looking
so
at it.
So it's kind of like hard to like live up to the hype if you're not looking at it from that standpoint. You know?
Yeah. No, I totally get that. Yeah. But yeah, that's why I didn't really like. I don't want to hate on it as far as like it's not like the best like superhero movie that I've seen. You know what I'm saying? But as far as like the social aspect, then yeah, it did hit its mark on that.
That's what's dope to me, because this movie can be like a Civil War or the Avengers, or even the Guardians of the Galaxy, but on surface wise, but it's much deeper than all those movies, you know, because it has
social messages.
Oh yeah,
you know, and that's what makes it more, you know, substantial. You know what I'm saying? I know, like,
it means
I love
more.
You know, Spider-Man, and I mean, it has, you know, the storytelling, you know, it reaches like, you know, with culture, tradition, history.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it makes me want to go watch it again.
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna go watch it again, because I saw it without knowing. I didn't tell him, and he's been asking me. So yeah, I'm definitely gonna watch it again.
I think, man, with T'Challa, like the character, I mean, shout out to, was it Chris?
Chadwick Boseman.
Chad, okay, yeah, and it's, man, he should get an Oscar for real. It's that character.
I think Michael B. Jordan needs to get some.
Yeah, that's what I was gonna say. Michael B. Jordan outshined Chadwick Boseman.
He really did steal the show. Yeah. When he beats him, that was my favorite scene, actually. Like when he like throws him over the water.
When he threw him over the water.
I thought that was so hype, dude. Like when he finally takes the crown. That was so hype to me.
That was straight from the comic books, right? That scene.
I'm not sure, like straight.
Yeah, I remember watching that Easter egg.
I like the man when he straight went into the throne and he called for the challenge, and then he goes, "I don't need the whole country there. Let's just go get it on."
He's talking about like, I killed all these people just to come back and kill you.
Yeah, that was dope.
Man, that was a dope line, dude. And his death scene was a dope last line, too. Talking about bury me at sea. Bruh, that was deep.
Oh, See?
With my ancestors, because they didn't want to be in bondage.
Yeah, it's kind of sad that he died. Because, like, he was such a dope character. Like, you would like to see him again, you know what I mean? But who knows? Yeah. Because, you know, they have, like, the tech there. Because he had a choice, right? He had a choice to be saved by T'Challa or to just, he said, I'm going
to
go out like a G.
The crown, it was all or nothing, man.
Yeah.
That was him. I mean, he was he was absolute. I know there's going to be more. There has to be, like a trilogy of Black Panther. I want to see a trilogy of Black Panther, man. Because, I think he might be the leader of the Avengers coming up next. I mean,
every other movie has a trilogy, and why not Black Panther, you know? I mean, I'm sure they are going to definitely do it, man.
I mean, just by the sheer numbers that this movie has done, and the sheer, like, popularity it will grow to. You know, there's definitely going to be at least two more down the pipe.
Ryan, The director, actually, man, he went to my school too, so I was like, oh,
really?
I just found out today. Yeah,
wow.
And like every movie, I think like his major movies, that Bay Area one.
Yeah, he's straight from Oakland, right?
Yeah,
yeah. He did a Fruitvale Station.
Yes, but that was with Michael B. Jordan. He did
also,
Creed.
And then he did a Creed. So,
and he has another movie coming up with Michael B. Jordan.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. Stick with that dude, man. Michael B. Jordan's going to be an A-list.
So, Bronze, I have a question. So, when at first was brought up, are they going to do a Matrix prequel with Morpheus?
Uh-huh.
And the rumor was Michael B. Jordan. You weren't happy about that. So, are you happy about it now?
Oh, yeah. I think so now. Yeah, because I could see his, like, how he... You know, I guess it's like a small sample. I didn't see him. Was it?
You only saw him on 2K.
Yeah, 2K. I guess I was stuck on that. But
what was his name in 2K?
He's growing. Young Justice.
Oh, Justice. Yeah.
Was it Young Justice? Or
Justice Young? Young, I think. But yeah, he's a dope actor, man. Like, he really, like, blew me away with that performance, man.
Everybody did really good. If I was to
name... And Michonne was a badass, bro.
Yeah. Oh,
man.
She has a significant role in Infinity Wars, right? Like, they have her in the...
she's in there.
She's in it. She's in it for sure.
I'm not significant, but she has, some long parts from what I hear.
I saw her running with Black Panther.
Captain America and Wakanda, with Hulk.
Right.
I mean, she's definitely in the movie.
So it's like, dang, you got Wakanda, like, taking out... It's not the world. We didn't see the world. I mean, it was the trailer, but I mean, because of course the soldiers or the warriors in Wakanda got the tech.
Yeah.
Especially that one tribe, you know, when they were going, that big battle at the end of Black Panther with their blankets. I don't know what they call, but like they had the shield, the force field.
Right.
So dope.
Yeah.
The rhinos. That part was
the rhino. Yeah, the
cartoony too.
Yeah. See that stuff like that. That kind of like that's kind of.
But I just accepted it.
Yeah, exactly. I accepted it after a while, after thinking about it.
Because that rhino got his armor was vibranium. His horn, like, was metal. I'm like, oh, damn, that's some... Get hit by that, man, you're done. Pretty sure they might use some rhinos in the next movie, Infinity Wars.
So what do you think? What is this for you? You never really gave your kind of ranking.
I'm gonna put this number two. Like, I really like Civil War. You know,
Civil War is far as like overall, like is Civil War. Is
it's
up
because
there.
I mean, for the airport scene in Civil War, like that was so good. That alone puts that pretty high on my list for that airport scene alone.
Yeah,
you get to see all of them fighting each other. I mean, that was so dope.
That was.
Civil War had a little bit of substance too, because with Bucky and Captain America, it's like,
and then
that's his homie and stuff, and he was trying to help his homie out.
And how he wound up killing his parents? Yeah, that was crazy.
Yeah, that was crazy, dude. Yeah, that twist. They had a good plot twist.
Yeah, a good plot twist
in that movie.
Yeah, definitely.
That Homecoming had a good plot twist. But the other movies didn't really have. I mean, I could care less for Iron Man 3.
Iron Man 1 was
that
good.
I'm still Tony Stark's without the suit. It's kind of like how it's Spider-Man 2. And I mean, that's cool. That's a classic, typical superhero type. And and Thor too without his hammer. But with this, man, it touches, cultures. And when I was watching it, my parents is from, in the Philippines, a province called Aklan. And there's a beach called Boracay. When I was a little kid, when my relatives would come and visit, they would talk about Boracay, like, are they going to start opening that up? Because basically it was,
it's like the Wakanda.
It was, there was no electricity, no nothing.
Yeah. But it was beautiful.
It was beautiful. And, I never saw it. I just, from what they were saying. And even when I was a kid, I was like, man, I don't want them to touch that. Even though I didn't even know what it was, but like the way they were talking about it was beautiful and pristine. And even at that age, I was like 9 years old. I'm like, oh man, tourist people, they're gonna like dirty the place up. And sure enough, they opened it up, and the province, got that tourist money, the revenue. I mean, economy came up on that, but at the same time, a lot of the tourist people, and now the president is talking about like shutting that beach down, that island down.
Really? And just closing it off.
It's gotten out of hand.
Yeah.
The tourist is like, he's leaving it up to the local government to try to handle that, but they're not doing a good job. The place is like dirty, and he's like kind of disgusted. He wants to like
maybe
shut it down.
Maybe they shouldn't open up Wakanda then.
You know what I'm saying? So like, but then, like, just like what I was saying with T'Challa's girlfriend, love interest, she wants to help. And there's that scene when they were walking, in the streets in Wakanda, like, there's so much, we can help them out.
Yeah.
And, there's ways to help out without, there's always alternatives. And
without going the violent route. And just trying to bogo, we're the number ones out here, and
And then also with when he had that conversation with what's his name from the other tribe, the guy from Get Out, he was saying, he was talking about like, man, I'm thinking about bringing some refugees, the refugees in, opening up our city. And He's like, I don't know, man. It's like, you know, you bring the refugees, you're going to bring their problems too.
Yeah.
You know, Trump, you know,
that hit me too when he talked about, like, you know, the refugee thing and it's kind of like, you know, things that we're going through now within our society.
Yeah, so that's what makes the movie powerful, because you know, it's, they do it to where it's an entertaining Marvel comic book.
Yeah, with, you know, underlining that's the social thing, right? Issues.
This is Disney money, and people's coming now. This is a good opportunity to send out like a message, you know, what's going on. And it's like, who does that? What other movie? You know, I mean, there's all these other independent movies, and, you know, it's like low key, nothing at this type of scale, nothing at this type of level.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, and it's expiring.
See, now that you kind of point people, like all the things know? Out that, you know, as far as like the social stuff, you know, I kind of get like, you know, how your point of view of how you guys see it. You know, I was just taking it as, you know, for what it was, me, you know, as far as like, but yeah, like there's a ton of like social issues that movie touches that,
right.
You know, that sends like a message.
I mean, it's like on all levels to me, like, you know, the top side, you know, it's like, it's a dope, you know, popcorn action movie, it's comic movie, like Justice League, like, man, if they can even do like a little bit of little message.
Yeah.
You know, it could have gone a long way for their franchise.
Yeah.
You know, but nah, they were just trying to, you know, try to turn around, make that money. You know what I'm saying? Like,
but what do you think of all the, you know, extracurricular stuff? Like, let's say Vivica Fox, right? How she said that, you know, Disney should donate, you know, portions of the money to the Black Panther Party or something like that.
I disagree with that.
Yeah, there's a lot of stuff that this movie stirs up to that's like, okay, come on now.
No, they're not obligated to do that. You know, I mean, because first and foremost, it is just an MCU movie.
Yeah,
but it was an MCU movie with a powerful message. Like the undertones, the underlying tones was there. But nah, they're not obligated to do that.
Yeah, for sure. So I think it just hits harder now, especially because of everything going on. You know what I mean? Like, this movie it came out, I think, at the right time. As far as, you know, with the messages within the movie.
It's like you growing up, right? Kids now, it's like they need an inspiration, right?
Exactly. I was saying, like, you know, this is a good, like, character for a young Black kid growing up. It's like, hey, man, this guy looks like me, you know, like, I want to be this dude, you know, he's a king, you know, he's like, he's super smart. So, I definitely, like the message on that front.
Role model, positive role model.
Yeah. And instead of just killing vampires.
Yeah. I like that. I don't know. Was that part two, Blade 2, Most Def? That, I think the song's called Eye for an Eye. I think I talked about that.
Right. I remember that track.
Yeah, dope. That's still a dope song to me. But, yeah, man. I don't know. Anything else you guys want to add on to that? What was your favorite scene?
Like I said, favorite scene was when Killmonger actually won.
Oh,
that was dope to me. Second favorite scene is when they're basically at the UN. And he says, now is the time for bridges, not barriers.
Yeah, that was...
I mean, especially, like, given today's world, for him to put that in a movie of this magnitude, I think that's so dope that they did that. And yeah, I mean, to me, that was, like, a really powerful thing to say. And
I like the... when they found out he was still alive, you know, one of the fishermen, you know, from that tribe that was in the mountain.
The gorilla tribe?
Yeah.
M'Baku?
Yeah, dude, his place was dope too, man. And every time when I watched the, you know, the trailer, you know, I thought, you know, that his throne was like in space or something, you know, with the bamboos hanging and, you know, the windows and you can see the, you know, the sky. You know, I thought it was like a damn, like, cockpit, you know, ship. But, yeah, it's like, man, his mountain top was pretty dope.
Yeah, I guess my favorite part was, the part when he threw Black Panther over. That was pretty cool. And then also the part when he came into, like, the council meeting and then they were kind of like questioning him, and then he goes, I have rights to the throne. He just kind of like, everybody was in shock, and like I that was one of the moments I think that stole the show, that where Michael B. Jordan stole the show for me. Is that scene?
Yeah,
where,
yeah.
Like when he got the Black Panther power.
Yeah.
And he goes back to his apartment with his dad.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Dude, that was a great scene.
Yeah, that was a great scene too.
And then talking about like what's wrong with the world, they can't see us. Dude, that was so powerful to me, dude.
Yeah,
that was great.
But whether
you got Luke Cage, you got like Black Lightning, but this is. I mean, as a movie, a comic movie, this is, man.
Okay.
Like my top two, man.
I guess, like, as far as like the fight scenes and just the overall action, to me, I think that was kind of what, you know, that made me like, oh, that was okay. You know what I mean? Like,
right.
But like, yeah.
Yeah, like, I guess that big battle scene, I mean, of course, it's not like a, I don't know, trying to compare like Lord of the Rings type. But
yeah.
To me, it was good enough.
We've seen
if you want to nitpick, yeah.
Like, I mean, better battles, like in Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
You've seen better stuff than that. But at that point, not that it doesn't matter, but it didn't really matter to me anymore at that point. You know what I'm saying? But,
yeah, because.
I mean, that, like I said, the action was not as great as other movies or other TV shows I've seen. But, I mean, like I said, it didn't matter to me at that point.
Yeah. So I would give the fight scenes a B. And the overall message an A.
A B. I love the visuals. I love the soundtrack. I love the pacing. I love the characters. The casting. Oh, also, but the casting. You know, Angela Bassett. That was kind of like a little bit downer. I mean, I know everybody couldn't, you know, shine.
Yeah, she didn't really like do a whole lot.
Yeah, you know, it was, you know, kind of a disappointment. It's like, okay, if you're not gonna have, you know, Angela Bassett, you know, shine or, you know, kind of do something. You could have casted someone else, you know, because to me, Angela Bassett, she should have been the OG Storm, like from, you know, from the first X-Men movie, you know, not Halle Berry.
Did y'all hear about that, though? How they're talking about doing a standalone Storm movie? Like, I heard that recently today.
I wonder who.
Actually, Storm and T'Challa are husband and wife in the books.
That would be cool.
Yep.
But then they would have to get the whole, you know, X-Men thing.
I think there was they were together, but then they broke up because
they are broken up.
I think Namor, kind of infiltrated Wakanda, flooded the city, and then T'Challa was, you know, he got mad, so he banished all mutants. You know, and including, I guess, you know, Aurora, she bounced too. So
would you say, T'Challa now is probably like the wealthiest superhero ever?
No, I mean, he is.
Yeah. I mean, he's got to be, right? I mean,
more than Bruce Wayne, right? Like, I think he's top Bruce Wayne.
Yeah, because I mean, vibranium is practically priceless. You know?
Yeah, for sure.
When Civil War was. You know, when I watched it, I looked up like how much he was worth, and he's a trillionaire, like a 10 times trillionaire or something.
Wow.
Yeah, and he's like super smart. I guess.
Yeah, like I said, he's a good you know, superhero that kids could like look up to and be like, you know.
Yeah, I want to go back to that scene. You know, he was checking out the tech. Yeah, that was funny, man. Like when he kicked his suit and like the blue light, you know, it's like storing that kinetic energy and that, you know, pushes it back. And I was like, so, man.
Is that something off the comic books, or is that something that they kind of did for the movie? Yeah, I thought that was interesting.
I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's. I want to go watch it again, man. Gray Miles, are you gonna watch it again?
Yeah, I'm definitely gonna watch it again.
Yeah.
Didn't Thor Ragnarok come out this? Week
November.
Oh, it's no. I mean, like on DVD, because I haven't seen it yet, and I need to watch that. I haven't seen it yet.
I think it's on digital already.
Yeah, I think it comes out this week. Oh, okay. You're talking about legally.
You can download. No, my friend said to download popcorn. My friend.
What's popcorn?
It's an app.
Oh, okay.
It's called Popcorn Time.
Popcorn Time. Okay, I'm gonna take your friend up on that.
Yeah. So, man, yeah, February was like, I don't know what the next movie is going to come out with. It's probably going to be May. I'm going to have Solo.
Yeah, probably not till like March, April. That's probably the next big movie.
Yeah.
Is that that Rock movie, Rampage, that's coming out.
So. Oh, okay.
What do y'all think of that?
Yeah,
I played the game, though. The game was
Yeah,
I
played the game, yeah.
Pacific Rim's coming out in March. That looks
Oh, yes. Next month. Okay.
Yeah, that looks kind of dope.
Yeah.
What's the next Marvel movie after Infinity Wars?
Ant-Man.
Okay. And the Wasp.
Yeah.
What did you think of the trailer for that?
It was okay.
It's cool.
Yeah, it is what it is. It's like a funny take on the whole MCU thing.
I mean, I enjoyed the first Ant-Man. I mean, it wasn't like, oh, you know, it wasn't like my top three, but you know, like, it made me appreciate ants more. You know, how he was cool with the ants. You know, I was like, man, I guess ants aren't that bad. You know, like, you know, I was sad, you know,
oh, his little homie died.
Yeah, it's like, sucks. I mean, you know, and you know, watching all those nature shows back in the days, like, you know, growing up, stomping on ants, and like, dang.
I wonder how many people would get mad at me if I said Ant-Man was better than Black Panther.
We'll probably lose some subscribers.
Yeah, I'm just kidding. By the way, it's not better than Black Panther.
But like we were talking about from the last episode, that you know, I guess he escaped, you know, because he made it out after Infinity Wars. If it's going down that timeline, you know, because it's Infinity Wars and then his movie.
Oh, yeah, I guess
somehow he must have.
You know, I guess Thanos doesn't take over the world because, I mean, they're back to worrying about, like, their old problems, you know?
So yeah, he's back to San Francisco.
Everything is more or less back to
normal. That would suck if it,
I guess,
they messed up and then that's kind of like before Infinity Wars, but it comes out after.
Yeah.
You know?
It's not like Disney where everything's all messed up.
Yeah.
Got two flashes, but I mean, I know. Well, you know, Fox is, you know.
So after Ant-Man, what else? What's the next big one? I guess. Oh, if you consider Ant-Man big, but I don't.
I think the next. I
mean, they have
Deadpool.
Oh yeah, Deadpool. Oh, I was talking about MCU movie.
MCU.
The next Infinity War Part 2 is going to come out. I think it's going to be next year.
Yeah, I think
right? But they're going to probably do a bunch of like solo movies before that, right?
Nah, it's coming out like next year. Like, because Part 1 is coming out this May.
Yeah.
Part 2 comes out next year.
So. Oh, so there's not. I guess they can't really do any solo movies.
Yeah, they're not going to make
they're
you
gonna
wait.
They're going to be tied up just, with that storyline.
Right.
Yeah.
They're not going to make you wait. It's just a year.
Yeah, for sure.
Man.
It seems like a long time though to not see a Marvel movie though. A whole year.
Nah. It's they're pumping it out, man. That and Star Wars. I mean, they good for like the next.
I didn't realize that years. Solo was going to be that fast. I thought it was going to be like Christmas 2018.
Oh yeah, I was kind of expecting. You know, I thought they were going to follow the theme too. Like,
yeah, that's what I was
Christmas
thinking.
Holidays, but. Yeah, it's in May. That's, you know, I hope it's good, you know. I hope what's her name does good, Daenerys. I want to know what that whole crew is about. Like, dang, there was a crew. It wasn't just Han Solo. It's kind of, like, ironic. Like, you know, his name is Han Solo. Of course, he had Chewie with him, but, you know, he had a whole crew with Woody Harrelson and.
Yeah, know, I think the Glover next. The next, what do you call it? Kind of like throwback movie they should do is like a bad guy character.
Oh, that'd be dope.
Like Boba Fett.
Who
or
would
something.
It be?
I don't know. Maybe like Boba Fett or
I mean,
like
Boba Fett's the only one that comes to mind.
Yeah, that would be kind of cool.
Yeah.
We need to do a Knights of Ren movie.
Yeah, we need to see that. What's that all about?
Yeah, like
we need to see them
really
in
explain
the,
that like at all
the third movie.
We might.
Yeah.
We might.
Have you guys seen Blade Runner 2049? Or
yeah, I saw it.
I did see it too.
You saw it too?
Dope.
Yeah, I saw it.
They're getting that art director.
Yeah, to do episode nine. Yeah.
Oh wow.
Sick, dude.
Yeah. So
sick.
If you like the way Blade Runner looked, you should like the way Star Wars looked. Yeah. So
see, with Blade Runner, like I didn't remember any of the first one. That's why it kind of like
it's been so long. Yeah,
yeah. I couldn't remember, and I kind of was kind of lost at certain points. Like, what's going on here? But then I kind of read up on it, the storyline, and you know what exactly happened. And yeah,
and it's better. Yeah,
yeah.
I think they made it to the point where you didn't have to, know the background. I mean, it would definitely help, but
yeah,
it stood, you know, on its own.
Yeah,
but yeah, sure. it was. Yeah,
visually the movie was sick.
Yeah, visually, and it was pretty much, you know, it was consistent with the first one, and I'm excited. I can't wait to see the looks of episode 9. I mean, if it's gonna bomb, if it's gonna be whack, I mean, at least it's gonna look good.
yeah.
So
no, I don't think this one's gonna bomb. The last one didn't bomb. I don't understand why the people are so. I don't know.
Yeah, it comes out next month.
So critical of it.
At the end of next month.
Oh, yeah.
Blu-ray.
Oh, yeah, it does.
Yeah. It's kind of quick, but yeah, I'm excited. Get that Steelbook. Gray Miles.
Oh, I got a pre-order already. Don't worry.
He already beat you to it.
Darn. Yeah, I need to get the Steelbook, too. But all right,
pre-order,
man.
Pre-order, man. Hit your pre-orders on Best Buy.
Okay.
So you can reserve it.
Okay, cool. It's not too late, huh?
Nah.
Okay. Man, all right. I think that's about it for this episode.
No pickups this week, but if you want to see how my All-Star weekend went, check out Gray Miles. It went quite well. I'll say that.
Really?
Yes.
Quick rundown. What'd you get, Gray Miles?
Got 3 gold toes, 3 cements, and the Big Bang foam posits.
Alright.
How was that in person?
I mean, people are like going crazy for them, but I'm not a fan of foams to begin with. So I really wasn't that jazzed about it. So I sold it no problem. Like, man, let's get rid of these right quick.
Dang.
Man, I really wasn't even tempted to keep them. So.
Yeah.
But I'll take that come up though.
Word. Let's do that, man. Yeah. Flip it.
Yes, sir.
All right, man. We out. This is it, guys.
Peace.
Thanks for listening. Peace.
Yep.
Baby, thug in it.
Soon, there will only be the conquered and the conquerors.